Hi everyone, Professor Mohamed Shah with you. Our subject today it's about the special desalination technique for by the use of solar energy. It's about linear Fresnel solar collector by the use of direct vapor generation desalination. Okay. Nanofiltration is considered in such technique, so you have to refer to our previous videos about nanofiltration and how can we run its model. First of all, you have to specify your folder. This is my working folder. Don't open your model from desktop, okay, in order to avoid starting problems. Okay, copy your model into your main working folder, then go to your, this working folder from here, from this bus. Okay, this is my bus. So, and then click here order to sort by name and group by type. You'll find your files, your references, your photos. Don't delete anything from here. Okay, this is our main model. It's extension with SLX, double clicking. Okay, this is our main cycle. We have linear Fresnel collector. It's such kind of moderate temperature ranges. It's temperature high temperature range, not up more than 300 degrees Celsius, 320, something like this. It's quite interesting for moderate applications with solar energy. It can operate molten salt. Sometimes it can operate special types of molten salt. It can operate oil, heat transfer oil, and surely steam, water steam. Okay, I have to adjust. Okay, adjust my. Okay, now. Cycle containing linear Fresnel collector, and we have here flash evaporation tank, and we have end condenser for condensation and preheating system. We need to use or utilize nanofiltration system. Nanofiltration system, we demonstrated that before. There is a bomb, feed bomb is going to bombing saline water or salt water through the membrane distillation system, and then we after removing TDS, some TDS maybe from 45,000 TDS as a seawater typical, and so we are intended or targeting to reach about 20,000 TDS before bombing that into the solar field. So the solar field is about to utilize a saline water inside. It's a special design, larger tubes. Okay, and after that we are going to after heating up the saline water into 300 or 250 degrees Celsius or 150 degrees Celsius, we need to flash this into the flashing chamber or flashing cyclone, and the steam generating through the flash cyclone should be condensed over or outside the tubes of the end condenser. End condenser is should be larger one, and the preheating, this seawater stream should go inside for condensation purposes and cooling water, and would be preheated by the steam. So it's some kind of double impact of the condenser or the cooling water or the saline feed water. It's the first target is to cool down and condensation, for condensation cooling down the steam coming from the solar field or from the flashing tank, and we will intend to collect the condensate. And the preheated seawater should be was especially lower in lower salinity should be bombed again to the solar field, and it's a closed cycle. The brine blew down should be removed to the sea. Okay, let's go inside and I'm trying to discover what is going on. First of all, you can double clicking here. Okay, this is some information. Okay, let's go inside. Okay, this is our main cycle. Okay, let's emphasize. Okay, we have to specify some important inputs. This cycle should calculate cost analysis, performance, and energy streams, and exergetic streams. Okay, let's begin from the first one is the pumping system, which is responsible to pump saline water through the membrane distillation, then the condenser, and from the condenser back to the solar field, and from solar field to the flash cyclone, and from the flash cyclone we have a brine, and steam goes to the condenser. Let's beginning from here. Okay, this is our pump. I should assign pump efficiency 0.7, 0.75, something like this. Inlet feed water temperature coming from the sea 20, 25, something like this, no more than this. If it from the surface. Okay, and for nanofiltration, we have it. We have to assign the following operating hours, recovery ratio. Okay, recovery ratio of nanofiltration no more than 35%, 30, something like this. Increasing recovery ratio, you have to refer to our previous models about nanofiltration. So we have here 30% recovery ratio, and salt rejection percentage. You can assign your these input pumps and realize the effect on your system. Let's go for the highest value, and feed saline water TDS. Suppose it's seawater. For you can change the range if you would like. Suppose it's seawater, so we have here 45,000 TDS. Okay, what is your module efficiency? The maximum module efficiency for nanofiltration, no more than after checking the manufacturer manuals and handbooks, no more than 45 meter cube a day. So suppose I am going for the maximum 45 meter cube per day per module, and pump efficiency for nanofiltration it is in the range of 85, something like this. Cost analysis, considerations, interest rate, load factor, and membrane replacement factor. It's about cost analysis. It's between 500 and 2500 US dollar per square meter of the membrane area, membrane lifetime, or plant lifetime. Okay, let's say quite normal for this. Okay, distillate productivity. In this one, we are going to assign distillate productivity, top cycle temperature, and pressure drop. Okay, let's go here and double clicking. We have for design, we can assign some tubes. What is your tubes diameter, tubes shell diameter of your condenser, into condenser, condensate flow rate. What is the gain from this one? Suppose I need 500. Let's go for 500 meter cube per day. 1,000. It's up to your design. You can change the range if you'd like, but from my experience, this range will be enough. Ambient temperature for exergetic analysis. This is inlet top steam temperature, because this one is coming from the flashing tank. What is your targeting? What is your target of your top brine temperature? What is your top brine temperature? For safety reasons, I would recommend 120 degrees Celsius, no more than this. No more than this. Surely it will reduce the dryness friction, surely no, but suppose we can change this and study the effect. We can number of passes through the end condenser. It's a special design. You have to refer to our previous videos about heat exchangers and types of heat exchangers. Okay, let's set up live. For performance, what is your effectiveness, condenser effectiveness, something like this, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, something like this. And let's go up for solar field. We have a previous video about this. So we need operating, what is your solar field? Top solar field temperature. Okay, suppose it's something in average. This is average value. You can change. You can add solar radiation model. We can attest solar radiation model. Ambient temperature. Some hydro losses. Okay, hydro mass flow rate. In order to categorize designing our solar field, we have to assign the hydro flow rate, because hydro mass flow rate is responsible for dividing our solar field into an equally segments in the solar field. What is your design aspect, such as mirror width? What is the width of your mirror? Focal length, collector length, inner tube diameter. Okay. Perform optical efficiency. This is your optical efficiency. Okay, clean. Okay, efficiency. I think this is should be one. Incidence angle modifier. You can change this if you would like. You can change this. Okay, and let's go for flashing tank. We have another video about this one. Okay, for flashing tank, we have operating hours. System lifetime and interest rate, no more than this. And let's go for, I think, this one. Okay, for electric power generation, for pumping system and so on, we need to assign this. For it is essential for cost parameters. Okay. What about cost analysis? We have interest rate, load factor, and plant lifetime. No more than this. Okay, you can go inside each unit. Suppose I have, this is a bombing unit. You can double clicking on the main block of the bomb and you will find the code here, so you can adapt this code or copy it or and use it in your research. Nanofiltration, the same, you can use this code. Okay, it's up to your work activity. Okay, let's hit run. This is my main inputs. I set your simulation time into zero and saving your model. And let's hit run and see the effect of such operative conditions. 120 top cycle temperature. Okay, and 500 meter cube per day as a maximum productivity of your system. Let's go for inspecting okay, this is power cost. This is power cost because of bombing system. Okay, let's go inside unit by unit. For bombing unit, we need to, this is your pressure losses. Pressure losses through the condenser, okay, and tubes and solar field. High pressure, this is top cycle high pressure because of 120 degrees Celsius. Feed temperature inlet, okay, and this is top cycle mass flow rate. This is top cycle mass flow rate. So, based on such issues, we need almost 30 kilowatt of power from the pump, and this is a specific power consumption of the pump. Let's go for nanofiltration. Okay, let's go inside and see. So this is total feed flow rate. This is your total feed flow rate from coming from the sea, and this is brine loss from the nanofiltration, and this is your product salinity because of this salinity should be go through the linear Fresnel solar collector. 2250 TDS of product salinity. We can reduce this, we can control the system in order to reduce this if you would like, okay, in order to increase the lifetime of your tubes, and it's up to your design, lifetime of the tubes of the solar field and the end condenser. This is brine blowdown salinity. Brine blowdown salinity, almost 63,000 ppm average salinity. Okay, number of modules, we need 9 modules of nanofiltration, total system area of nanofiltration, module area. This is pumping power, so the nanofiltration, specific power consumption of the nanofiltration. And we have here membrane replacement costs, total fixed costs, total variable costs. So you can double clicking here and you can adapt this. We adapt the cost analysis of nanofiltration. And this is unit product cost. If you intended to sell your product cost from nanofiltration, only nanofiltration, you have to sell it by this price. Okay, but it's a saline water because of the salinity is almost 2200 TDS. Let's go for the end condenser. It's quite interesting. Okay, L steam, it's about to the condenser is 120. This is L enthalpy. Okay, L cooling water is 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, let's go for outlet cooling water temperature. It should be around 80 degrees Celsius outlet from the end condenser, because this one is going toward the linear fresnel collector. This one outlet cooling water temperature should be mounted toward the solar field. Enthalpy of this one is liquid enthalpy. Inlet steam pressure, this is temperature of distillate temperature. This one condensate TDS, TD means temperature of the distillate. This is condensate. It's around 60 degrees Celsius, quite logic. From 120 degrees Celsius down to 60 degrees Celsius. Enthalpy of, this is enthalpy of the distillate. Condenser low pressure. Okay, this we have high pressure, 1.9, almost 2. And this is your low pressure, 0.199. Okay, almost 0.2. Condenser area should be around number of tubes of the condenser, tubes length, thermal power, irreversibility rate. Okay, for solar linear Fresnel, let's go for here and top cycle pressure. We have pressure losses, outlet enthalpy. This is water. This is should be water, liquid enthalpy. It's not a steam. Useful energy from the solar field. You can double clicking here and you can use the code if you'd like for solar field. And thermal losses, absorber losses. We have thermal losses and this is absorber losses. Okay, absorber from the solar field. And I think this is not absorber, this is absorber energy, it is not losses. Absorber energy, I have to change this one. Absorber energy. And if you subtract this thermal losses from the absorber energy, you will get the useful energy. Okay, and total solar field area, we need this. We need solar field, something like this. Segment area, okay, segment, the number of segment, we need 200 almost and 20 segments. Okay, segment widths. Okay, and number of mirrors, total number of mirrors, we need something like this. Distance between mirrors, collector efficiency, this is your collector efficiency. You can collector irreversibility rate, exergetic analysis, and exergen. You can send this data to data to data inspector. Suppose I efficiency of collector, okay. Because this is collector efficiency, and click here. I'm sorry, I just one click and choose send it to data inspector, and the same for I irreversibility rate, I collector in kilowatt. Suppose it's in kilowatt. That's okay enough for this one. And constant analysis for linear Fresnel, we can discover our constant analysis. Let's go this one. Okay, double clicking, you can assign interest rate, plant lifetime, solar field specific cost, land cost, and piping cost, because it's the system contains a lot of piping and loops. Okay, let's go inside and see. This is our total capital cost of the solar field. Okay, we can do this. Okay, linear for the collector total capital cost, and this is your hourly cost. Okay, US dollar per hour. Okay, let's go for the flashing tank. We have another video about this one. We made another video. Okay, so this is our drain fraction. It's five. It is not enough, surely. So we need to increase the pressure. We need to increase the pressure of the top cycle or decreasing the pressure of the condenser. Suppose I can decrease the pressure of the condenser below the 20 degrees Celsius. So I have another. I can increase the temperature of the steam from here. Okay, let's go for this one. I can increase the temperature. So if I increase the temperature, I would increase the pressure, therefore and generating more steam. So if I intended to do this, I have to care about my salinity, therefore I have to adopt more, increasing more recovery ratio of your system. You have to increase more recovery ratio of your system, okay, to take care about this one, or try to decrease the salinity of the sea, of the seawater. Okay, let's go here for the flashing. Okay, so drainage fraction, we have to take care about this one, and total flow rate. This is total flow rate, so the solar field massive flow rate because of a lower percentage of the steam, and we have water content in through the this is water at the bottom of the flashing tank. You can discover your volume of the tank, direct cost, total annual cost, flash tank hourly cost. What is your yes, this is the enthalpy of the mixed region. This is enthalpy of the mixed region because we have a flashing, so we have some kind of, suppose this is a top pressure and this is a lower pressure. We have here HX, which is the enthalpy at 5% of the steam, and we have HFG, latent heat, liquid enthalpy. Okay, and we have vapor enthalpy, condenser. This is condenser temperature, nearly the same of distillate temperature, as you can see. And we can discover some design aspects such as tank height should be 4 meters height because of lower steam content, flash tank diameter, drain and vent. More interesting, let's go to this is cost of the cost analysis. So we have here condenser hourly cost, bumping hourly cost, total hourly cost considering flashing, considering linear Fresnel collector, considering nano filtration and this is your total water price. This is reflecting the price of your blend, this price that you are going under such circumstances, you will sell your water by this price. So you can enhance this, you can control your system, it's up to your design. This is our cost block analysis. You can edit, you can adopt new correlations, you can add more inputs and outputs. These are your, for the same, for all units, these are your outputs. This is cost, this is function name and your inputs. Okay, suppose I need to enhance this system. Let's inspect this by selecting time infinity. Okay, simulation time, set your simulation time into infinity. And I would like to increase the temperature and see the results on my system. Okay, and let's go inside the flashing tank. What is my dryness fraction? I should send this to data inspector. Okay, dryness fraction. Okay, and let it be. I need to discover more results. More results. Mass of the steam. Mass of the brine of the. Okay, tank volume. And design. Let's go here and send all of this to data inspector. And I think we can send some cost considerations for each one. Okay, for linear Fresnel collector. I think this one. Okay, it has. Okay, and let it be this one. We can send all of this. And CTOs, okay, a number of segments, mirror, and air collector, total field area. I would like to send all of this. Okay, bombing unit power, okay, it's already sent. Okay, let's go here. I think we need to, I will try to explore this effect on the flashing. Especially just I need to increase the dryness fraction. Okay, so I have to go here, double clicking first, okay, and go inside again to the flash cyclone. Okay, so I preparing my panel and saving, hit run, and I'm trying to change. Let's hit run and see. Okay, now our system is running, so I am increasing the temperature. As you can see, steaming top cycle temperature increasing. So that means I am demanding more steam. I'm demanding more steam. So therefore, let's go for 20% of the steam. So the solar field will serve me with, I think, 200. Okay, let's go for more steam and see the effect on the cost. And okay, enough for 30%. Let's increase the productivity. Let's go for more productivity. Sure, the productivity will affect on the tank design. Increasing product. Okay, I'm increasing my system productivity. Okay, up to for example, okay, 1500, 1600. Okay, that's enough for now, and stop our simulation time. Okay, so let's go. You can inspect your system. I'm sorry, unit by unit, but you can go here and data inspector and see. Let's go here. I think we have an interesting results. We can compare results if you would like. Let's add more slots and see. For example, what is our dryness fraction? I think dryness fraction, membrane dryness fraction. Yes, this one. Okay, as you can see, increasing the temperature would increase the dryness fraction. And our flashing tank hourly cost, and we have here what about total, this is M total mass flow rate, a design of the flashing tank, vent, drain, and diameter. Okay, and let's go for M feed and brine. Okay, salinity of the product is there. I think it's constant because there is no change in salinity. Number of nanofiltrations. Number of nanofiltration would increase, I think, yes, or decreased. Okay, specific bulk consumption and brine and feed. We got this before. Total power. Let's go for total power. Total bombing power, including the general bomb of the system and the bomb through the nanofiltration. And total water price. This is our total water price. Let's see. Yes, it decreased because we increased the steam, and the steam temperature has a massive effect. Has a massive effect on your system performance. Total hourly cost. This is total hourly cost. Decreased because of the steam temperature. So the conclusion is that the steam temperature or drainage for increasing the drainage fraction has a better enhancement or a remarkable enhancement to your system. However, demanding more productivity would increase the hourly cost of your system. But at the same time, in general, this would decrease your total water price. Let's go inside. Total water price almost decreased from 8 down to 4. So this is the cost of your including salinity, including materials, including brines, including chemicals, and so on. Finally, I would like to thank you very much for your interest in our model. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you very much.